In this video, I'm going to show you how to create your own signals and slots in Qt 5. I will make some example, like when officer gives some order, which is signal, and then the soldier will receive the signal and do something, which is the soldier will implement orders in its slot method. And let's create a simple console application. I'm going to call it my army. Next. And we have simply one entry point. And I'm going to create a new class and call soldier. And it will inherit from QObject or any Qt base class which whose grandparent is QObject. Just make sure their original base class is QObject. And then we have this our soldier. I'm going to define here because we are going to simply print something as some. Okay, the soldier will receive the signal from the commander or officer and will do something, which is a slot, the receiver implementing their method. Let's say receive command. And these things should be implemented here. Soldier receive. Save it, I think. Receives command. That's quite interesting. Public slots. Okay, that's the point. Yeah. And here we are going to simply say print some string called command I received, and that's a simple receiver. And then our officer create another class which we call it officer, and this officer will emit the signal. So how to create signal? Simply call it command, and then officer command, and we are going to emit this command in, let's say, send command, and we have officer send command, which is simply void officer send command. And we are going to do this. This is the signal of officer. Officer. Yes. We are going to emit this command. And in that case, so we have our signal and receiver, the slot method, and we will implement in the constructor. Once we create a officer object, this connect will, the connection will build. This, and we need a soldier. Let's then we will in create a English. Sorry, spelling wrong. Connect. So we connect the sender. This is our officer sender. Which signal we want to send? Officer signal is called command, and the receiver is our. And our soldier has a this is a slot which will do it. Okay, now we have this connection built. We create signal, slot, build the connection, and then we have create a officer here. Officer and officer, correct. And how is the officer being triggered? Send command. What happened? Our officer has a method, normal method, which triggers signal. Okay, so we are going to call this one officer send command. The result is the soldier should print, the slot in soldier should print this message. Okay, save. And let's see how it looks like. Something went wrong. Small mistake somewhere here. Yes, we made it. And another information, since we have connect, of course we have disconnect. We have let's make officer, since we made it. We are going to make some method called disconnect, and officer. This connected, we are going to, here is just demo, so I make it just, there's better ways to get this object returned, and this pointer here is actually a QMeta object called a connection. Is a reference of this connection, and you can use it to disconnect. But here we are going to just copy this, which is exactly the same, just disconnect the signal. And here the way soldier, and let's see what's going to happen if we send twice. It should print the message twice. And if we disconnect, let's call it officer, we have this disconnect function. which is disconnect single and slot, is supposed to just print out once. Yes, that's what we, and of course, this is just a simple demo. If you, when you're trying to do something, you are going to make some functions based on your function, you can put this connections, disconnections between in different methods and different conditions. Just to know that the sender receiver, these concepts, yes, just make more examples and you will get the point. And that's it. Thanks for watching.